Hey guys, Mike from CCTV Camera Pros here. In this video, I'm going to show you how our Viewtron automatic license plate recognition cameras can be integrated with gate access control systems, like the ones you go through at a homeowners association communities that are gated, or government facilities that have gated entries. And so that's one of our Viewtron license plate recognition cameras that you see behind me. And although I don't have a gate here at our plaza, I'm gonna use two alarm lights in this example. And the blue light is gonna represent the gate. So I have both of these hardwired to the alarm relay output ports on the back of our Viewtron NVR. And you would wire up a gate the same way I'm wiring up these lights. These are generic alarm relay outputs. It doesn't matter if you're wiring up a gate or a siren or a light. You wire it up the same way. It's just a dry contact. So what I'm gonna do is in our license plate recognition zone, I'm gonna set up in the database that the license plate that I'm gonna have on the front of my car is gonna be in an authorized list. And you'll see, when the camera recognizes the plate and looks in the database and sees that plate's in the authorized list, it's going to trigger alarm relay output port 1, which has the blue light connected to it. Now, I'm going to remove my license plate from the database so it's no longer in the authorized list. And so when the LPR camera detects a license plate and it's not in the approved list, it's gonna trigger alarm relay output port number 3, which has this orange strobe light connected to it.
This is how I have the alarm lights wired to the Viewtron NVR. This picture only shows one alarm light, but both are wired the same way. The lights do not have an alarm relay input port, so I simply wire the power supply of the light in line with the relay. Most traffic gates will have a dedicated dry contact input. The 8-channel Viewtron NVR has 4 alarm relay output ports. I have the blue light wired to port 1 and the orange light wired to port 3. The blue light is simulating the traffic gate opening. It will light up when the LPR camera detects an authorized license plate. The orange light will notify us when an unauthorized license plate is detected. Please note that I could connect a traffic gate, or in this case our blue light, to the IP camera instead of the DVR. This is because Viewtron LPR cameras have a built-in alarm input and alarm relay output ports. The Viewtron LPR IP4 also has RS-485 and Wiegand ports that can be used to trigger opening of a gate instead of using an alarm relay. Here's the live view of our LPR camera on the Viewtron NVR. This is how everything is set up. If I come down here and select Settings, and then from the main menu, select LPR, this brings me to the LPR configuration screen where I can select the camera I'm working with up here, and I already have detection enabled, and I already have my license plate recognition zone defined. I can click this display range to show the size range of the plates that I configured. So next, if I click on recognition, you'll notice that I have successful recognition and strange plate both checked off there. And then I have the alarm output set to trigger alarm output 1 in the case of successful license plate recognition. If I go into the strange plate settings, you'll notice that the alarm output is set to alarm out 3, which is the orange alarm light. And then last, if I go into the license plate database, you see I have an authorized group here and I have one plate defined in that authorized group. So if I expand the authorized group, here's the license plate that I'm gonna have on the front of my vehicle. And then I just have the plate number here defined, but I could put into the database a vehicle type, the owner, and a mobile phone. But the important thing is that it's added to the authorized group. So I'm going to go back into the LPR camera settings, and under recognition, I just want to show you that I have the schedule set to around the clock, 24/7, but you can set a custom schedule if you like. And then the plate group, I have the authorized group checked. That's the only plate group that I have in the database. but that's the group that we're using for this application. So I'm going to close out those settings now and then go back to the live security camera view on the NVR. And this is the full screen view of the LPR camera. And so in a second, I'm going to drive my car that you see in the distance towards the license plate recognition zone. And I have our alarm lights overlaid on top. And remember, the blue one is simulating a gate. So I'm going to slow down and stop as if I'm stopping at a gate. And then as I entered the license plate recognition zone, you could see that my license plate was recognized properly and it was identified as being in the authorized list. So next, we're going to remove my license plate from that authorized list. So I'll go back into the main settings on the NVR, select LPR again, and then go into the license plate database. And I'm just going to delete that entry. So there's no plates authorized now. And we'll save those settings. And then we'll close out this configuration screen and go back to the live security camera view. So now I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to drive up to the license plate detection zone. We'll put our alarm lights in the upper left again. And then this time you'll see when my license plate is detected, it's no longer in the authorized list. So it's going to be identified as a strange plate instead of an authorized plate. And it's going to trigger that alarm relay output number 3, which has the orange light connected to it.
Guys, I hope this video has been helpful. I want to mention a couple other things before we wrap up. I recently worked with a friend of mine who owns a gate access control company down here in South Florida. He's actually an amazing software engineer and inventor. Name of his company is Tap to Open. He fully integrated our license plate recognition camera systems with his gate access control system. So this is live with his system in a number of communities throughout the United States. It works great. We can help other access control companies integrate with this camera the same way I worked with him. I have some examples online, some code that I wrote that I open sourced that'll give you an example and get you started with integrations like this. That's using the IP camera API, not the alarm relay outputs like I demonstrated in this video. So these cameras and these Viewtron systems are extremely flexible for integrations. Also, if you have a large project, we've partnered with the company that does enterprise software development. So if you have something, some complicated workflow, or you need to roll something out on a large scale, we can help you with that as well. If you have any questions about anything related to license plate recognition cameras, AI cameras, or security cameras in general, you could reach out to me directly anytime. I can be reached at mike@cctvcamerapros.net. If you want to learn more about our Viewtron LPR cameras and see additional video demos, please visit www.cctvcamerapros.com/LPR. Thank you for watching.